r/AskReddit. What's the worst case of rich kid syndrome you've seen? I've posted this before, and I need to say first off the bat that this is about my best friend and she is the best person I know, i.e. not normally rich kid or anything. I was complaining about how I was short on money 1 month, just couldn't go out to eat, because I had to pay rent and pay for tag renewal all in the same paycheck. She looked at me, super seriously, and was like, "Don't worry, they send you those in the mail for free." After a long discussion, she learned that in fact, her mom had been paying for her new tags every year. I worked as a bouncer at a high-end nightclub, the biggest boner of a rich kid, straight out of Malibu's Most Wanted. Gets a VIP booth and bottle service, racks up a massive bill trying to act like a baller. His credit card gets denied and he has to call his dad to come down at 1:30 a.m. because he can't order any more bottles. His dad comes down in his pajamas, obviously ashamed and furious at this douche of a kid, ends up embarrassing the shit out of his kid in front of his whole group of friends. He takes the kid's keys and is about to leave when his kid makes some shitty comment and goes back in the club. The dad's about to walk away after he apologizes for his son when we offer to drag him out the rough way. He smiles and accepts. That kid hit every door and step on the way out. Not the best story, but was one of the most satisfying experiences working at that club. Dunno if it qualifies as rich kid syndrome, but when I got out of the Navy I decided to use my GI Bill at one of the Penn State satellites. I was sitting in the cafeteria drinking coffee and typing up a paper when a girl sits down across from me and opens her backpack. She pulls out a sandwich bag and looks at it in disgust, then looks me dead in the eye and says, "I don't even know why I bother, my mother never cuts off the crust." I let out one of those high-pitched short laughs like, "Is this girl for real?" Oblivious to the tone of it, she says, "I know right," then asks me if I want it. I looked around thinking I was getting pranked or something, cause this shit is too stereotypical to be real, and I just assumed I was being filmed. She shook it at me and gave me a "well, look." So I said "duck it" and took the sandwich. She then pulled out her studented card and bought a crap ton of French fries. That sandwich was awesome. I think the bread was homemade and it was stacked like a Dagwood. It had all kinds of expensive looking meats and Dijon mustard. Serious gourmet shit. I know this girl's mother will never see this, but I just wanna say someone appreciated that sandwich. This case isn't too bad, and it's a bit funny. I became friends with a kid whose family was really well off. He was a really nice bloke, but a bit sheltered, and university was the first time he really had any independence. But he had very little sense of what the value of a dollar really was, since his folks got him what he usually wanted, compared to what normal people would spend. There was one particular time he wanted us to eat at a restaurant, and he assured us it's really good. So we all rocked up to this place and the price for main courses started at $40 to $60, which as poor uni students we couldn't afford. But when he realized this, he was so embarrassed he got his folks to pay for it. He's finally wised up a few years later once he got more independence away from his family and made his own money, and remains one of the best blokes I know. A 12-year-old family friend got an iPhone XS for his birthday, then deliberately shattered his iPhone 8. I saw a 7-year-old daughter having iPhone XS with Dior ostrich skin cover. The cover was more expensive than the phone. Mommy got it for her birthday. In high school, a kid was bragging that he got in his third fender bender in his old car, 3 years old, that his parents gave him but he hated. So his parents were buying him an entirely new, current year, car to incentivize him to drive better. "Hey son, you wrecked your new car? Well, fine. We're getting you a new one hoping you'll drive better. Genius." My mom's friend used to buy new clothes each season and throw out the old ones. She had to be taught by her husband to save them for the next year. Edit. This happened way back in the 50s. Her family was very rich, and he was just a normal guy. Worked with this kid who was a good kid, but completely disconnected from financial reality for most people. He'd just moved out west from another state and was trying to get on like a normal adult. He went to buy a new car and was shocked that they couldn't just bill his dad for it, since they didn't know him. He ordered a bottle of wine at a restaurant and the sommelier said, "Certainly, sir." Then the sommelier whispered, "Just for your knowledge, sir, the bottle is $700. He looked straight at him and asked, "Is that a lot?" The sommelier honestly didn't know how to answer. Good kid. And he got a lot better. But he just didn't know. Once he casually told his mom he needed some help with bills and she deposited $20,000 into his account. My friend's parents had a dilemma because they both bought each other new Mercedes for Valentine's Day. A guy looked at my $2,000 beater car in college and commented that it must have been really cheap and guessed $15,000. Edit. For anyone curious, it was a Kia Rio 2005 with 120,000 miles on it. I worked at a Starbucks and we hired a new guy, who I was training. At one point, I had to show him how to clean the restrooms. I grab the bleach and hand him a pair of gloves and he looks at me in disgust and says, "We don't have a maid to clean the bathrooms?" He quit the next day, lol. When I was in boarding school, one of my co-boarders handed me some mail saying, "Do you notice anything special about this envelope?" When I checked it out, I realized his face was on the stamp. He was royalty. Edit. I will add another too. Kid from Taiwan also attending same boarding school. My advent calendar had little chocolates. His had a remote control car, Sega Game Gear, etc. etc. Another teenager, 16, arguing on the phone to his grandfather he didn't want a Porsche. He wanted the Ferrari. Went to a destination wedding in Mexico resort. Rich kids rented a golf cart, tore through the streets and flipped the cart, injuring people and causing a huge commotion and traffic jam. A Mexican lady comes out and begins to scold them for their behavior. "You wouldn't act this way at home." Rich kid responds, "I promise you we do." It was the earnestness of his reply that got me. Edit. He really believed he was placating her with that response. There's gotta be a German word for something being funny because the other party is aloof to their own behavior. My brother works at a rehab center for the kids of wealthy parents. He's always got stories, but the one that sticks with me the most was a kid who was in trouble with the law and doing rehab before his court appearances, you know, to look like a better person and hopefully the judge would go easier on him. He was mopey one day and my brother asks him what's wrong. The kid starts talking about how tough the whole experience has been for him. How it's been so hard on his family that his parents had to sell his house to pay for his rehab. My brother felt sympathetic and says, "Damn, that sucks that your parents had to sell their house over this." To which the kid corrected him, "No, they kept their house. They had to sell mine." I knew a girl whose allowance was $90 a day. She got into trouble so they cut it to $90 a week. How old was she? Assuming this was high school, how did she manage to spend 30,000 a year? One girl from my high school got breast implants for her 18th birthday. Her mom joined her as a mother/daughter bonding activity, followed by the daughter getting a brand new $90,000 Mercedes as a high school graduation gift. I work for a dentist and her son is a spoiled brat. He was at the office one day because she had to bring him to an appointment later that day. He got bored and went out wandering around some of the local shops. He came back a little while later and without any preamble walked up to her and said, "Give me $80. She asked him what it was for and he just repeated himself and she gave it to him. Edit. Did not expect this to blow up. I'll answer a few questions if I can. So the kid is 19 years old. He was 17 at the time of this incident. The father is in the picture but my boss, the dentist, is the main breadwinner and disciplinarian of the family. The husband is more like another child and just works here and there and lives off her money. She tries to act tough and instill certain morals and values in her kids but then turns around and caves to all of their demands. For example, her twin daughters are going to university next year and instead of staying in a dorm they demanded a two-bedroom, two-bathroom apartment. They refused to share a bedroom or even a bathroom. At first she told them absolutely not but they whined and complained and she caved. This will be a two-bed, two-bath apartment in Toronto by the way where rent prices are through the roof. My boss is very much about appearances and from a young age got her kids accustomed to her privileged lifestyle. She created monsters. Edit 2. Yes, they are totally like Jean Ralphio and Mona Lisa Saperstein. This is pretty tame, but it's what I got. I used to work as an after-school babysitter for a loaded doctor couple with two kids. My job was mainly to pick up the younger kid from school and hang out till his parents got home. He was a good kid, but coddled and immature. He was in 5th or 6th grade at this point. Oftentimes he would not be at his classroom when I came to get him. And the school campus was huge. Different buildings, courtyards, playgrounds, the works. If he wasn't at his classroom, I had to comb the whole campus. And he was rarely in the same place twice. He had a cell phone, but usually ignored its existence except for playing games on it in the car. The school was in the city and I had to park on the street. A couple of times I wound up with parking tickets because, despite having stuffed the meter with enough quarters to presumably result in ample time, the search for my charge would take much longer than anticipated. After a point, I mentioned this to him, calmly asking that he respect my time and stay in a set location so that I don't end up with a $25 ticket again. He looked at me with a good-natured shrug and said, "Well, that's not much. You can afford that, Sonny. Your parents paid me $140 a week and I was in college. I know you live in a $1.4 million house and your dad buys you an expensive new toy every Sunday, but with the money they're forking over for your education, someone ought to have taught you the value of a dollar by now. But honestly, he was a nice kid. They moved away and I hope he's doing well." This kid back in high school was whining, I mean literally whimpering, that he had to wait something like 6 weeks for his custom-built BMW to come over from Germany. Went to HS with this insufferably spoiled kid. Family had a couch in their home's elevator, and classical European sculpture. This was in the US. Kid talked down to about the less fortunate on a regular basis. Once made fun of me for picking a coin up off the ground. Knew this one guy at my college who didn't understand why everybody is so worked up about student loans. I remember him saying something along the lines of, "Why don't people just pay the tuition up front?" He was also quite sheltered. I could absolutely survive on my own. My parents just pay for my food and house, but I pay for everything else. If I got a job, I could pay for my food and house too. Said at 18. In the middle of a discussion between two middle-class peers who were talking about saving money because they had to pay for their own college and living expenses. About 5 minutes prior to this conversation, both peers had ordered the cheap dinner options and declined a shopping trip later that night. While rich girl was talking non-stop about buying the best most expensive souvenirs for her friends. Once tried working a regular person retail job and quit within a couple weeks as it just wasn't right and I didn't like it. Read. Had actual responsibilities for the first time. Moved cross-country for an 8-month education course, where her parents pay food, rent, and school. They also gave her a debit card which replenishes up to $500 when it hits $50. She still posts Snapchats with captions of that broke person life over pictures of her getting Starbucks every day, and insists she could survive on her own. Constantly suggests the most expensive options for meals, activities, etc. And tax on things like, "We can just split the bill. I know you're saving, but it's just amount at least $50. You'll be fine, right?" Then gets upset when people can't afford to spend time with her, or when someone dares to suggest that she helps cover costs. Friend got a theater with an arcade built over their family's 12-car garage. Parents didn't want the 5-year-old sister to be jealous, so they hired an architect to design and build her a fully functioning playhouse with a bathroom, AC, and bedroom. Just the tip of the iceberg with this family though. Update. Lots of comments. I will try to round out the image. And for what it's worth, no, neither I nor my family is rich. We just lived really close to the family and my dad and mother became close friends with them. They were on the whole really nice and innocent people, drunken on the spoils of wealth. I can say I genuinely love the family. Firstly, one commenter was correct. This is not really rich kid syndrome. And no, these are not normal rich people. These are ultra rich. Probably richer now than they were then. For example, George Bush Jr. visited the family's house to hold a fundraiser for his second campaign. This was not a typical rich family. Their father built a mini racetrack for his Lotus Esprit at his lake house. Also built a mega yacht with a garage for what most of us would consider a large boat on it. Surprise. He never really used it more than once or twice. An impulse purchase. The house, more aptly called a castle, was filled with game from African safaris taken in the 70s and 80s. The wife bought a popular fast food franchise unavailable in our area because she didn't like having to drive 30 minutes to get what she wanted. Once when I was swimming in the waterfall pool with the sun, my mom called and reminded them I need to be home for some sports event or something. And we hopped in their Bentley dripping wet. It was the first time my feet ever touched a fur floor in a car, soaking wet at that, at the Millennium. The father was into tattoos and regularly spent tens of thousands to fly the best tattoo artists in world and from Japan and LA to work on his Yakuza style sash tattoo. I could go on, but the number one thing that I think might qualify one in the family for rich kid syndrome is that the father, who inherited his family business from his father, sold the business overseas in the late 80s. The company was the only reason the town had to exist. Ever since, the community has been recognized as the most depressed in the state, and the schools unequivocally the worst. My fiance's cousin. He managed to crash 4 cars while still in high school because his father would replace them. When he moved on to college, he got kicked out of several apartments for owning a dog when they weren't permitted. He told me he didn't care though, since his father also funded his continuous stream of new housing. From what I last heard, his father is now paying for his long-standing cocaine habit. Someone's sister got $600 shoes, so the parents got the other kid's shoes of the same price to stop their complaining at it. It was a birthday present for the first kid. I should have said that. I wouldn't say rich kid, but definitely spoiled brat who thought he was rich. Befriended him in 5th grade over our interest in the UGR trading card game. First time I hung out at his place, I noticed just how littered with stuff his room was, some even unopened. I showed him some rare card that I had recently pulled from a pack. He got super jealous and angry that I wouldn't trade or sell it to him. He immediately got up and walked over to the family computer and booted up a site where you could buy cards and various other toys and such. Completely ignoring having me over, he's now on an online shopping spree adding stuff to the cart. After adding a few things, he yells, "Where's the credit card?" And immediately his older sister comes running up the stairs to yell, "Kyle, Mom said no more buying stuff online," and closes the website and shuts off the computer. Kyle then proceeds to have a crying tantrum on the floor, and I'm just standing there over him in shock at what's happening and how he's acting. I slowly stopped hanging out with him until completely avoiding him as his temperament got worse. Kid wasn't even rich either, if I remember correctly, both of his parents were cops. Babysat some rich kids. A couple gems were when we were watching a movie and she said someone was ugly because they were poor. Another was that they left their stove at the side of the road for hobos. Kid was about 11. Edit because people are commenting about the stove. I have no issues with things being set out at the side of the road and wouldn't hesitate to grab something and leave things out myself. It was the hobo thing that irked me. Bro, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, mate. It's free and that's a great price.